it is peculiar to consider that during the golden age of steam locomotives, popular songs were made commemorating railroad disasters. Had any of the composers been witness to a real train wreck, perhaps they might have chosen something else to write about. Lackawanna Railroad had one of the finest safety records in the country. On June 15th, 1925, in Rockport, New Jersey, it mattered little because no one can control the weather. Number 1104 was eastbound from Washington toward Hackettstown. Rockport is located in an area they call the Rockport Sag. It's a downhill grade, and the engineers always hit it at a good rate of speed to have enough momentum to carry them up the far side of the hill. Just before the train came through, a heavy thunder and lightning storm had washed out Hazen Road.
Well, they'd scraped that the day before, scraped the road, and the dirt was loose, like, yeah, and then so much water came down from the rain, they washed it down on the tracks.
The train was probably doing 70 miles an hour. The locomotive hit that obstruction at about 3 o'clock in the morning. The engine derailed, but continued upright for several hundred feet, and then flipped on its side. The next two cars jumped the track. The first one smashed into the engine. The second one flipped over on top of the engine.
Well, the steam came up through the cars and just, I hate to use the term, but almost cooked these poor people. Just hear them holler, crying like, you know. You can hear them all the way from the railroad up here. And people were crying and screaming and terrified, which is certainly understandable. They were burnt inside and out. That was what hurt so. In 1925, none of us had electricity out there, or telephones, or anything like that. And it was a case of carrying kerosene lanterns there to look in these coaches to see, you know, what could be done to help these people.
I found a little girl was in the spring down there along the river. Her head had been cut off. That blonde-haired girl, I found her. I helped get the engineer out of the engine, too. Two or three tried, and when he tore up so bad, I volunteered, and I got down the hole, and I put it in the basket. Cotton funeral pole.
There was a porter on one coach, a man named Oscar Daniels. He had been with the passengers since Chicago. He knew the people well, and they knew him. After the wreck, to shut out the steam, he tried to close the windows on the coach that was on top of the engine. But in doing so, he was severely scalded. In spite of that, he got out of the coach and had enough presence of mind to seek help. He went with all his terrible burns a half mile across the fields to the game farm office. But when he got there, the phone was out of order. The storm had knocked out the one telephone in Rockport. He came back. When he reached the wreck site, he collapsed and died. The wreck train car was rebuilt and named the Daniels, an honor unheard of in the history of the Pullman Company.